this was just the basement of the house, and it was a bit something and nothing. And what we did was take the stairs out, so it's completely separated now. I've split the leasehold, so it's its own legal leasehold title, and the houses, so they're completely separate. So I could sell the flat or I could sell the house, they're completely separated. So again, that's another way to make money. So I made money just by doing that legal split. We took the stairs out, that where the French doors are, that used to be a window, and where the window is, that used to be the door into the back door into the house. And then there was like a kitchen and a pool room and a coal shed. And the coal shed is now a bathroom. And I took some walls out as well so that it's just a big open space. So we've basically got a massive kitchen, living, dining area, and this is where I used to do my classes. So I built this room for me. So I used to have everyone around the table there to do my mini masterminds and stuff. These are all steels. So there's a huge steel going across there, and there's a huge steel going across there, and the stairs used to be here. So this was just the walls that we took out were scary. I mean, the structural engineer said, make sure you're on this side of it when you do it, because that steel is holding up the entire staircase up through the other three floors. So it was a big job. Looks nice now, but it was scary at the time. Because this is now a separate flat, we had a new water feed put in here, and we were actually getting condensation problems. It's cleared up now, it's done. So it's one of the things I wanted to check today, that it's sorted. But you know, that was just an ongoing what's going on, and actually it wasn't. We thought it was a leak from the new water supply coming in up there. It was actually condensation, because the cold air, the warm moist air was getting attracted into here and hitting the cold air where it was all open. So we've sealed it all up and it's fine now. A lot of the time, if you send a specialist in, they'll over engineer the problem, whereas what I like to do is go in and go, well, it could be this, let's solve that, it could be this, let's solve that. So I tend to work with, you know, the trades and the builders, and we look at it from a logical point of view before we get any specialists in, because a lot of building is common sense more than anything.